Gravity versus Team Liquid, and both teams start the day tied for fourth and are looking to
get a lot of value out of it.
See what kind of items we could have coming into this one. Teleports are up. Triforce has not finished the Black Cleaver of Quas, but still, Hauncher can slice down Piglet with that Sheen and Phage damage. It's going to be the teleport.
Dragon should take home guard off. Oh, he didn't even have it.
Yeah. Hauncher comes in. This looks like he's not going for the ultimate.
Fight.
It should pretty much be able to have this. Dominate not close enough. Silver Ultimate goes off with the disengage here. Coming from Gravity, Hauncher definitely wants to use that, and I think that's all she wrote about it. Bunny Fufu goes down with a nice... Actually, didn't even get his Monsoon off.
Yeah, it is going to turn into a 2v1 up there momentarily as Dominate heads on up. No wards for Hauncher to speak of.
Oh,
that is...
No ulti. Can't get the last one. Boomerang hits again. Going to pop him up. The move block does not actually get to him. He couldn't dash forward, but it looks like Hauncher will still go down in the end. The red buff really contributing to locking that one down with Boomerang after Boomerang. Yeah. Very, very slow early game. Kobe took to what? Oh, could be a fight here. And it looks like they are going to get out alive. Turret goes down on the top side.
And Team Liquid are able to walk away with Dragon number two. They are zoned out of the mid lane. So once again, Gravity looking to trade a mid lane turret, but...
Now they want to fight it. On to Phoenix. Gets blasted around. He's going to be able to throw down his Zhonya's, but... Flashes over the wall nicely. Didn't know if it was up from the other side, and Gravity still wanted the kill. Chaos Storm raining down hell on Gravity and dominates over the wall. No Seeker to take his prey out, but the hit comes in from Altec to take down Dominate in a tunneling mistake.
Look out. Dive on Gravity. They actually don't even have to focus Piglet first. Phoenix is a decent target.
Oh, they don't have eyes on this one. Hauncher comes in for the home guard.
Ooh, has to hold out.
Yeah, ult himself out of that one. Chaos Storm is still following Gravity here. It's going to be move that gets stuck. Move taken down. There's the Lichbane empowered Q from Phoenix on that Victor, and you can see the damage just chunking down one of the more tanky members of Team Gravity.
Oh,
absolutely zeroed out with the dissonance and the rest of the damage assist. Of their own drum, as
that
they
was...
say, we want the inhibitor instead of the fight.
Those were some...
Oh, flash. Okay, the disengage instead of the engage here from Gravity. Hauncher's going to be going down, the guy that they really need to cause chaos in the fights. 50 seconds on these death timers now.
Speed advantage that they have really gives them the option of disengaging. Hauncher, though, again, he doesn't have flash.
That's Talisman of Ascension. He has a team, though. They have it special. Unbreakable Will very, very late, which still makes him look like a tasty target. He flashes over the Tri-Brush to safety. Quas, level 17, gets knocked back here. And it looks like they may have enough to take him down. We've seen this before. It gives Team Liquid time to catch up in the fight. Is that what happens this time, though? It seems as it's worth. And Gravity are choosing the right targets. The Zhonya's at the perfect time. Keen still has his as well. Tazania's in a bad situation. Now they're able to focus on to Dominate. That time of Phoenix pausing gave Gravity the time they needed to look at their targets, prioritize, and snap down onto the right ones, taking down Quas and Dominate.
But it looks like they want to save it for a team fight.
This is tough for Quas. I figured Quas would almost want to be in the fight here, trying to get his Gnarbar up on minions with the team.
No flash after
this
that
This could be difficult. Specials in on this one. There goes Hauncher to the back line. It's kind of pausing the fight. They're stalemating, trying to figure out which target they can take down. A good hit coming in there. Dominates very, very low, though, as they get a good amount of damage onto Keen. Everybody's piled up into one spot, but Chaos Storm cannot come out at the right time. They're able to start shutting down Team Liquid. A double kill for Piglet as he finds his mark, but they are still pushed back into their base. Great Boomerang Blade coming in from Altec as they get a finalizing fight to tie up the kills and start to open up the base a little bit more onto Team Liquid.
All right, two inhibitors down is going to give them so, so much control.
On the hunt, as they think that Team Liquid is going to engage on the fight, they saw that Quas was coming in and figured something might happen. And now Gravity's actually going to go in without the ultimate on their side. The inhibitor turret actually, it does just go down. They're able to fight under it now. And that's going to be Dominate falling as Gravity kites backward nicely. Quas trying to hold him off as Hauncher has already fallen in the fight. But Team Liquid slowly losing their base each time. They're not coming up with an advantage on these engages. Cannot even get in. Especial zeroed out and dunked by Altec as he comes in for the engage. That could be it here. Liquid heading for their Fount for Solace. The Nexus turrets have already fallen now. 9-8. They finally start turning things on from the side of Gravity, able to pinch down and suffocate Team Liquid here in the late game.
All right, so that should be able to clean it up here for Gravity. What a victory. That's going to move them up to try and take that first spot next week.
Make them look really good. 7-3 once they finish the Nexus, coming into this with 6-3, the same as Team Liquid. And they do set themselves apart. One last hit, the ball cannot make it.
Oh!
Catches him on just the end. And Gravity will have the 2-0 on the summer split over Team Liquid. Get these out of here. I don't need these headphones. I don't need these. How's
that? Gravity just looking stronger and stronger each week.
Pulse versus Cloud9 for our next match today. And yesterday, Cloud9.
It comes down to it with the heal.
Ellie once again. Oh boy, it looks like they just want everything under the turret here. You can see Xiaowei Shao pushing the lane in as hard as possible. I feel like Incarnation has to know something's going on. Xiaowei not giving any aggression up on this one. They go right for him. Rush is the first one to tank it, and they do it very nicely. Also, making sure everybody's matched up here.
They really want to make this flash play here. Lemonation level 6 wants to get the stun to start it all off.
Oh boy. Great flash by Xiaowei Shao. They still want it. Right under the turret. And that's because the rocket was the follow-up over the shoulder of his teammates.
Where can Cloud9 do it next?
Oh, Impulse. Here's that combo, though.
Impulse had their way with Incarnation in mid. So they go to the top side now, trying to shut down the 17-0 balls. He's bringing out some damage, but not enough with the Haunting guys just finished up.
See any entry into the river. They were very safe with that aggressive play.
Oh, they're going to try to hit this one up immediately. The Ignite goes down to the Lemonation. Apollo has enough to kind of just stand through the Tibbers. It was the call for balls to come in, however, that could change the fight. And I think Impulse has actually calculated this one so everybody can get out. Balls comes off of the Overheat, but doesn't have enough speed on Scrap Shield.
A little bit disjointed for Cloud9. Turtzel had plenty of health there, and the Alistar was able to get in the middle of it. Medios now caught out in enemy territory.
They don't get what they want, so they want to provide a way to get more. That also takes down Cloud9 as they get it. The Lemonation is also there for the counter. Pink Ward's pushed up here by Cloud9, definitely giving them the advantage. They know that Adrian just walked out, but he was still on the side. There is the Shockwave coming in. It's going to be a Chaos Storm kill onto Xiaowei Zhao, but they still get the Retribution on Incarnation. Impact's taking quite a bit of damage as Rush comes in. A ding ding, a new challenger approaches, and they get the Twisted Advance onto Sneaky. That was the worry. No escape for the Jinx, and now a no escape for Lemonation. Rush coming up big as he connects the Sonic Wave, the Resonating Strike to boot, and he will not follow through on the Meteos.
Looks pretty good for Impulse here as far as the mid game goes.
Fearless movement, that's got to be a scary thing for Cloud9. Impulse not really worrying, knowing they can set down wards without even being skirmished on. And they're the ones that want to start the fight. Sneaky in a bad spot. Unbreakable Wills tanking the turret from the beginning and completely dunked as Sneaky. Balls is going to go down thinking he can actually assist. And the I think I can may continue to play through for Cloud9. They get right in the way of the Shockwave. That's Lemonation. One more hit is Adrian in range. It's going to be the command move coming in from Xiaowei Zhao. Another kill. And somehow with one person under that inhibitor turret, four go down, or rather outer turret, four go down for Cloud9.
Man, it's like Impulse just went into a candy store in in the pick ban phase and they just got everything.
No way! Oh, Meteos looking to get a final push on the wave.
This is really hard to watch, actually.
So, items surplus now for Team Impulse. They have Frozen Hearts, the Lockets of the Iron Solari finished. They want to engage even more, and not even a chance to breathe or blink coming in from Cloud9. The connect here going on to Meteos. The connect on to Sneaky. His mind's telling him, you know.
Minions
on the turret. Aren't going to allow too much to flash kick for Sneaky. Absolutely dunked with the last auto attack from Apollo. And now here comes On the Hunt once again. In range as much as they need to be. One last hit to Lemon Nation. Rush gets the face of the mountain coming in from good guy Adrian. And it looks like they're still able to engage. Impact completely tanking that shredding inhibitor turret. Ball's now in the wrong spot at the wrong time. He's going to go down. They're going to be able to drop down Meteos. That's the ace for Impulse. 19-3. 26 minutes in, they're inside Cloud Knight's base.
What a massacre this game is.
40,000 to 53,000 right now.
We are past the halfway mark now for Cloud
Knight. Oh boy.
There's
the On the Hunt right onto Incarnation again. There's no escape for him or Sneaky in these fights, and they continuously go down very quick. Balls looks to get the first loss on his professional Rumble career as Impulse makes their way into the base. Almost another ace as Sneaky's in the bottom lane, not even present for the fight as Cloud9 is looking to squeak out a few more objectives on the map.
Well, he's got an inhibitor turret, but it's going to cost him a Nexus.
There's a hashtag worth here, at least for Sneaky. The team is on to the Nexus for Impulse. Cloud9 looking to get another loss in the record book here. Just under 30 minutes, 24-3 as Impulse turned it on. They're able to take down Cloud9 and go 2-0 on the split against them.
One of the most brutal beatings that we've seen this split.
That's the team that doesn't let go, that's not okay with having a little bit of a lead. That's the team that wants more of a lead consistently.
Solo Mid versus Counter Logic Gaming. Now, earlier in the day,
a lot of fandom on the line, and this game will be a good determinant of who's better next for the end of the split.
Oh, Smithy.
Oh, go into the pulverized Smithy. He went down first yesterday. He goes down first again in a bad spot, again at the wrong time. Double lift, and the rest of the team have a lot of follow up DPS here.
The base stop,
though.
How does that happen? He'll be late to his warrior upgrade. He was late with early pressure. He's going to be late to this entire game for the most part, and the rest of COG has to make plays.
Sivir ultimate teleport in.
Yep, Zion got in already. Nice hit. They are going to be able to get a slow onto Turtle here. He's not going to be going too far without boots, and he goes down.
To go for something.
Santorin looking to go in here. He's level 6 double buffs.
They have good coverage for the fight. Double lift just below them with zero mana on the fight,
though. The longer they wait here, the more likely it is they're going to teleport in.
So much free damage from that dragon. Very, very low goes Zion Spartan, and very, very down he is as well. Pole Belter right in the front, not where he wants to be. He's trying to walk out of this one. Smithy's able to come up with the dragon for the team as they hightail it out of there. One harpoon, the attack, two harpoon as Dyrus overheats. It doesn't activate.
Not
he already had that first one shot. Now on to double lift. He came into this one with no mana, trying to help the team and just put himself in a bad spot. These guys.
The CLG gank squad with the Sivir ultimate, so he's going to try and use it on the bottom lane.
Oh, Dyrus going to go down. Not much he could do here. Turns and retreat for the flame spitter. But that definitely goes to Aphromoo, and that's definitely not what they want. Warren looking with Lustboy to dive into this one. The Void Ooze hits. Santorin looking to go in. Lustboy gets a very nice three-man pulverize. Santorin still does not want it just yet. Lustboy's going to die by himself. He's left. Looks like the dragon will also be picked up here in a bit of hesitation as Zion Spartan came in with the teleport. It's what caused TSM to balk on engaging.
In a mid-game teamfight like that is a little bit perplexing.
Very big miscommunication there for TSM.
Oh boy.
Double lift though.
Oh my lord.
He didn't even need to hit the full equalizer. Hot damn. Dire is cooking up.
They can't use to pull off a flank and make that all in play on CLG.
Not the one they want, but it is the one that they want. Santorin heads in with the Jarvan Quattro Cataclysm. Locks it up for the team. Trist, Rumble, picking up kills. Dyrus and Wild Turtle very happy about that.
Beard
the Shurima slide into double lift, tries to cut off another finger, and he's going to succeed, but goes down.
I mean, we're waiting for the game-changing play. All summoners burned right away. What a wombo by TSM, but with Bjergsen going down there, Baron damage is low. It's a lone defense right here. Pobelta coming in from the backside.
Zion, charge that bar!
Artillery gonna rain down!
Level 14 Gnar, gonna get blasted away and off the river. What timing by Wild Turtle. Team Solo Mid now grabs the Baron. They're gonna turn onto Zion Spartan. If they can get that close onto Pobelter, not gonna be good. The flag and drag hit. Pobelter too close for his own good, and he gets a whack to the head from Santorin.
Great plays all around from Team Solo mid. Pick up the Baron and basically ace CLG.
Plus point playing offensive line and defensive line for CLG. He is all over the place.
So much control the team has in the play as well. I think Bjergsen really need to get his ultimate on that one. Lustboy going in. This could be much like the Dragon fight where the team's not able to follow and they have to leave him out to dry again. Getting a little hyphy on that one, but they are able to get the pickup kill onto Polebelter, a little too close to his own base wall.
They should be able to get one after
that's
that.
That's probably worth at this point. The main way to clear is Polebelter, and they still have their turret killers
support,
up.
Ooh, support for mid, that's like a pawn for the queen. You're definitely happy if you're getting that situation.
Great trade.
Great trade from Team Solo mid. Onto the turret now. Bjergsen in. Back and forth. Ping pong with Polebelter. And rather ping pong with double lift. He goes down. And it's going to be Zion Spartan out to the side. He can't do much, but watch the inhibitor go down.
Minutes that could reflect otherwise.
Yeah, they do have teleport on Dyrus. They could accelerate the process of the super minions pushing into the base to try and draw some attention of CLG away, but they're not even going to commit to it. They have five people bursting down the turret.
Yeah, Santorin basically gone.
Yeah, Santorin gets grabbed. That means the hook is down. So is the pressure. He dunks Zion Spartan out of midair. Santorin coming big on the Jarvan plays lately. Lustboy under the turret where he needs to be with the Unbreakable Will on and gets out with just a sliver of health. They're going to be on the inhibitor. They get a perfect dive and engage there without losing anybody. And they're going to wait it out. They're going to say, we want more of the base. We have another inhibitor to take down. And they got eyes on it. Blowed in the middle for TSM. And there's the hook. Bjergsen again waiting it out to make sure he knows where the hook is going. The initiation's on. Aphromoo gets locked in the back, and they actually take the Lantern into the Cataclysm. So double lift brings himself to safety in that one.
Empty.
That was from one equalizer. The Polebelter took 98% of his health. Beautiful placement in the corridor there by Dyrus.
Oh.
The inhibitor's down.
It's over.
It's over.
May not be a fight that they want. Zion Spartan over the wall, able to take one kill out. Staves off a bit of the aggression, but TSM, the DPS guys for the turrets are already in the base. Bjergsen and Wild Turtle able to crush these down. They turn on a double lift. He gets stabbed from Azir Soldier, taken down. A double kill for Bjergsen, looking for the triple if he's got the slide, but he decides to stay in place with the team, and they decide to take down the Nexus team. Solo mid on the split. 2-0 over CounterLogic Gaming for the summer in the NALCS. TSM takedown CounterLogic Gaming.
Yeah, and 4-0 for the year. This means CLG would not be able to get a win against TSM unless they meet in the playoffs.
Spring and summer, 4-0.
We're heading into our next match to see if that will happen. It's Team Dragon Knights versus Team Dignitas. And now for 5 weeks. And overall, we're just seeing this pretty much trade equally. The attempts, you're seeing, you know, well-played lane harass and well-
Oh, the hook!
Actually, that one's amazing. The Ignite is on. Seraph cannot possibly live through this one. The first blood goes through to the Thresh and Smoothie with a great hook on a core JJ. Nearly makes him die. So many heal force, but still a great first blood for Dignitas. Being pulled, Dignitas spending a lot of time down there. Now it's to the bottom lane. Core today gets the Lantern just in time. Gets stunned up, though. Looks like Valkyrie gonna do nothing. The kill goes through to Emperor. An amazing explosive cast by Kez makes Kiwi can flap, and here comes Gamsu. Gonna knock Kez right back into the turret. Gets the kill. A one for one. All said and done.
Play it being a more comfortable environment for many of the players to be here. It can all make some pretty big differences. Kez at the forefront of these engages.
Feeling really happy. A lot of burst damage coming across, but Kiwi Kid will still get picked off. Just the further chase by TDK is going to work out. Emperor did not use ult for that. It's going to be back up in about 10 seconds.
And this is the first time they're getting a turret edge, taking an interior turret. But will Team Dignitas be able to punish? They're all about getting the proper flanks. That's how they've been able to win their games. And they're flanking now, Freak.
Flash Hook's going to miss, but he has the flave. He wants Kez, and looks like the answer is he does. Flash away, bites him, and Helios blocks it, though. Gets the knock, but TDK does get the kill. They're sorry, Dignitas gets the kill onto TDK's jungler. And the chase continues. Gravity Field comes back off a cooldown used, but the dive in towards Ninja. Nice Hemo play to push back Kiwikin, and Dignitas do not want to continue this fight. A 1-0, but top lane tier 2 had died.
Going into Dragon Take, very late Scrying Orb. That's a 3,000 health Baron.
It's gonna go.
Yep. TDK's gonna have to rush in for fight.
Well, the knockup's gonna land on the two carries of TDK. Sorry, I'll keep Dignitas, keep getting it backwards, but the hook comes in. Kiwikid has already died, a 4v5, and outruns Dignitas. No chase available, Civ ulti's already ended, so.
This would be a time to fight, though, for the third dragon.
And here's the Civ ulti pop right on the Kiwi Kid. They go. One more hit will kill him. The Boomerang Blade's going to miss, though. And in comes Gamsu, finds Emperor. The AD carry goes down. His first of the season. And as the battle continues, soldiers in the right spot. A knockup onto Seraph, but he's a pretty durable Vladimir with all this spell vamp. No second kill comes through, but it does mean Dignitas have control of the map. Dragon safely to Team Dignitas, and TDK is going back to mid to clear. But Dignitas not really done, still looking forward.
Gamsu wants it.
Finds damage into Seraph, but loses all his health bar. Gamsu forced to ult away from the fight, and in comes the hard engage. Core JJ gets dropped, these AD carries constantly dying. Seraph the backline pops, Azonia stays alive. In comes Helios. Oh, wow. Bunch of damage from Shifter cleaning up the fight, but he's the only guy left alive on the team. Nice Q by Emperor, takes him down. How's that for an Emperor's Divide, and TDK win the fight.
Work. Zonia-zing right afterwards, but Dignitas, this.
This is maybe a bit too bold because TDK is right here. The hook comes in, they find Kiwi Kid, maybe not the worst target.
They got Ninja.
Goes down, Core JJ is still alive, but Kez and the Vladimir are here. Core JJ will get himself killed. Emperor joins the fray as well, but it's still a couple of kills back and forth, a two for two. Seraph gonna get dropped easily by Shifter.
Somehow, Team Dignitas puts all five of their team members within the Baron Pit and win a fight.
Here's in 30. You wait another two waves, and it ends up not mattering in the first place anyway. Baron attempted, though, before these ultis do come back up. A lot of damage going through. Dignitas must know about this. A lot of wards coming down.
They're not in the right
health.
Position to fight. They can try and steal, but they need time. Now they're going for the fight.
Blue team is slain Baron Ash. That goes to Team Dragon Knights, and right on top of it they go. Gamsu taking a lot of damage, but Lantern right back out. Core JJ locked up, can't QSS. Will try to kite away Seraph, and he's still going to go down. Two kills picked up for TDK. Make that three. Seraph does get killed, but it's a 4-for-1 with Minidhip dead and Baron.
Seraph did so much work in that fight. The Sivir ultimate is up in these long death timers, plus the Baron buff could mean TDK's first win of the split.
Well, you said it'd be a hard road. Maybe 9 wins required to make playoffs. Well, they're going to start with their new lineup with a win right off the bat. They knock Team Dignitas down a peg. TDK going to get their first win on the board, and maybe the miracle season has begun. With the new roster, these guys are undefeated. Oh, hold up! The inhibitor respawned!
The inhibitor didn't respawn.
It's not even over yet.
And Team Dignitas is reviving, maybe?
Oh, no. They can't. It can't possibly.
They got it.
Okay. Well, everyone throws for a loop. Again, TDK with the new lineup, fresh start, kind of 1-0. What if the miracle season happens? Yeah. Again, it's Team 8 versus Enemy Esports, and this now...
They aren't going to be doing damage to each other unless they really want to take damage. The shields for both these guys can hardly be outdone.
Good flash. Oh, no! Dodo missed it. Didn't expect the flash. Bonding won't matter, though. Inox certain to fall. Dodo claims the kill, but either way, a great roam for First Blood.
Yeah. So I feel like Enemy has to just really snowball this game.
Oh, we'll see if they can do that. Trashy Porpoise in a battle. Porpoise wanted to fight, but here's the Shen ult. The Trashy Porpoise to run. Pops Ghost, pops the ult. Shen has to wait 2 more seconds for the taunt, but gets rooted before it can happen. And here's the TP back in from Flares. Who is he going to ult? He goes for Porpoise. They don't want Calitrolls. They go for the jungler. Porpoise will die, and the kill goes to Otter, thankfully for Enemy Esports fans. We'll see if...
Yeah, a million CCs.
Even the auto attack will do it. In fact, here comes Porpoise. The flash already down from Flares. He's got nowhere to go. Nice anchor block. The kill goes to... Oh, Calitrolls?
Yep.
Oh, and a hard engage in the bot lane. Body drop has no one to save him. Easy kill picked up by Nien. I want to see that one again.
Oh, because he tried to disrupt it. Hasn't worked out yet. This time it's punishing.
Gonna try to disrupt Nien right here. Ghost from Olaf use as well. A lot of move speed. Shen comes in, but it's gonna be a lot of damage coming through. Kalista will die out of the turret, but Shen has arrived in the back line. Otter pops summon heal to run away, and Trashy gonna do what damage he can, but Otter got bound. Calitrolls flashes in for the kill. Dodo gets the credit. A late TP from Flares. He will ult on a Calitrolls. Trashy's about out of mana, though. A good hook to buy some time, but I don't know if it's gonna be enough. A dark binding hits. Trashy is completely TP means nothing, and Rek'Sai holds top lane.
They burn a lot of stuff. They end up trading 1-for-1 now, but they're going for a continuation dash.
Re-engage, stun into Ignite, Black Shield used, but doesn't really block much. More damage coming in, the auto attack, body drop gets the kill. A flash bind from Flares, 2 auto attacks till Dodo dies, but no range left to get it. Clears a wave, Rek'Sai still pushing top, though, might equalize. And the lane's better pressured by teammate. Enemy go for the early dragon attempt. The mid laner is actually still stuck there. Vladimir far away as well. This could be rushed down in time. Corpus could kind of join to smite this one away. 1100 health goes in, and the smite comes through. Trashy gets it, force rolls away, binding hits players who had already been in the correct spot for it. Kelly Jones front line. Nian gets jumped out of the back line, and ulti in from Nautilus, and Timbers takes him down. Bided up gets the kill. Trashy traded back on. Out goes Corpus, pops Vladimir in the middle of it all. Two kills for two. Inox forced to run away. Who's going to get what? Ghost keeps him safe. Vlad steal the chase, two kills for two, Dragon to enemy esports, all fair. And the lane's better pressured by teammate. Enemy go for the early Dragon attempt. The mid laner is actually still stuck there. Vladimir far away as well. This could be rushed down in time. Corpus could try to join to smite this one away. 1100 health goes in, and the smite comes through. Trashy gets it, force rolls away, binding hits players who had already been in the correct spot for it. Kelly Jones front line. Nian gets jumped out of the back line, and ulti in from Nautilus, and Timbers takes him down. Bided up gets the kill. Trashy traded back on. Out goes Corpus, pops Vladimir in the middle of it all. Two kills for two. Inox forced to run away. Who's going to get what? Ghost keeps him safe. Vlad steal the chase, two kills for two. Dragon to enemy esports, all fair. About 3 weeks ago, hard engage comes in. Nice early black shield from Dodo. And of course, you can't focus the support of a Kalista. Flare's caught up in a turret, but the re-engage comes back through. And in comes Dodo. Two-man ulti in. They're going to turn right back out of the Morgana. A lot of CC comes in. The stun still lands on a Vita drop. Supports get traded back and forth. Corpus in the front line. The double AD carries are around. Enemy was pushing the correct lane. Vladimir had recall to Corpus. Wow, jumped on Shadow. Not gonna matter. Just taking him down. A miss rotation and the re-engage was Kali Trolls. They dodge the stun. They dodge the taunt. He flashed away. Dodo forced away from this fight, and Golden Glue shows up only to ghost and run away. The slow lands from Trashy. The ulti gonna force Kali Trolls away. Black Shield used very conveniently, and a quick pause into this game. We'll see. Yeah. Bypass the front line.
It's the great peeling quest that Dodo and Yen are gonna be on.
Good old, wow, he got just in range.
That doesn't help.
Nope, Corpus is getting jumped on. You're seeing the hard dives are working. Three kills on the body drop. He's actually got the most kills in the team. And they re-find Dodo. He went back to mid. Calitro's also going to try to run away. He taunts out, awkwardly enough, and gets away for himself. Inox still poking, and Nian losing even more health.
Hey, that's another fight. We said enemy, if they are to win, it's by finding fights where they have the numbers advantage, because they have tools to create numbers advantages with all their initiation. And they get two kills right there on Dodo and Corpus. Time to turn to Baron. This could be a major swing, and enemy actually pulling out a win here.
Well, the team's going to come defend this one. Golden Loop goes in, goes for body trap, stunned up and lost.
Doesn't even have ultimate up right now.
Be careful though, there's no jungler, which means the smite should be easy. It goes over to enemy esports, and now the battle continues. Golden Glue has the zone. Yuz gets stunned through it though. Ooh. Can't pop it in time. Explodes, and enemy getting three kills and a Baron unanswered. Corpus takes basically no damage. The talisman's popped on all sides. Golden Glue looks for the flank. It's a bit of damage down. Otter trying to run away, and the taunt nearly lands on a body drop. Ooh. They might kill the Annie off. More flashing out, and a massive set of roots come out of the Varus as Flares is in the back line. Morgana ulti popped to stay alive. Gets stunned up on it in the end, though, and there's the back line push. Butted up, gets killed. The armor tanks maybe starting to work out now, as exactly who can enemy esports kill? Flares rooted up. A great taunt, and Calitros locks in a kill for Nien. Nien still on the chase, but be careful. There's always some counterattack available. Calitrolls running backwards.
The actual DPS on Baron is low from teammate, but the secure is very high. If they could do Baron without taking much damage, the idea is they'd peel for a fight afterwards. It's very dangerous, though, keeping Yen in the Baron pit if enemy could dive on them. Sivirolt is not up, so the dive isn't as powerful, but yep. Both Righteous Glories are off cooldown for enemy, and that's a talisman.
Our full health for this, thanks to the Vorpal Blaze. They jump in on a Flares who is trying to flank, but he's not exactly Hecarim. Stun lands on Golden Glue. They force the Vladimir away a little bit, but he's going to lifesteal tank Flares now. He is safe on this side of the fight. They will knock down the enemy esports top laner. He's crushed off, and no kills come through on the backside. Enemy esports down a kill. Teammate Calitrol is just zoning the team away. Good play.
It's gonna be a barn burner. Dragon in 25 seconds. Very close game right here. 2,500 gold difference. Teammate, they're continuing to pressure this Baron, but if they're not careful, they're just gonna give a fifth dragon to enemy. They may even give up their lives here if they get too low, and if they take too much poke, there's still a Righteous Glory on two members of enemy for a potential engage.
Now the binding's going to miss half health now. Binding up goes for the hard engage. The end cleanses it away.
It whips.
The fight has begun. Kelly draws the front line. Otter forced to run as fast as he possibly can. QSS is that one away as well to not take any more damage. Kelly draws Chuck Low, goes down to Ricochet. Boomerang Blade comes across well, a one for one, but
ooh,
Inox knocks the kill through. Two kills for two kills if you count the death on.
If Inox and Otter do get caught out, the squishies will still die. But for instance, flares can now actually threaten Cali Trolls.
You're seeing the damage that True Damage Burn is doing, 50 damage a second. It's basically Ignite on an auto attack, still landing it. And Enemy Sports find the full collapse, and Cali Trolls taunts in, but will go down. It's a 1-0.
Cali Trolls can ult in 10.
Careful.
And how low can they get flares?
Now the bind drops to about 2/3 off the follow-up. Looks like Enemy's gonna turn right back around. Golden Glue to buy some time. He does not have Zonya's though. Goes in towards Inox. The Baron was hitting, and Inox might in fact get himself killed for it. And in fact, the shutdown does come through. Flare's doing some damage to the back lane. Actually, a double kill for the top lane. Nautilus runs away, but Baron kills off Otter. Now Calitrol's tanking up the dragon buff champions. Nian back in the fray. Calitrol's very low, but so is Trashy. A ton of Ren spears, and a kill comes through. It's a 2-4. That teammate is winning. Minions in the bot lane or not, it means Baron's being attacked. Enemy overstepped their bounds, and teammate looking to take Baron if they can.
There are 4 waves approximately of minions killing their inhibitor in the bottom lane as well, and they're still fighting against an aspected Annie right now, trying to 2-man the Baron. This is chaos, Freak.
Well, Nian's gonna have like a 7,000 damage Ren. That's a bit of an exaggeration, but still, Baron is gonna be almost for sure secured unless Vita Drop goes for it right about now.
Just, he's got to be safe. He's going to wait for it to go low, over-securing with a monstrous Ren. But they lost their second inhibitor.
All right.
While getting Baron.
Went for it.
Thing is, he's worried about getting one-shot by Golden Crew, which is basically what happened last fight, even with the Maw.
Yeah.
Again, though, Calitrol's on the side. He cannot get picked off yet again.
A hard dive in towards Golden Glue, who's forced to run. Shenult popped onto him, but the re-dive of Porpoise pops. The thing is, Porpoise is alone. He goes in to get himself killed. Another 1-0. Baron buff on teammate or not. It's 50 seconds with 2 inhibs down.
Exactly what you don't want to happen when you're a downed inhibitor. You have to shrink your potential faults in those situations. Do not be far away from the base, but enemy catches Porpoise and Cali away from the base, meaning they now have a numbers advantage to pick up a third inhibitor.
Third inhib is absolutely massive. Top one will respawn soon enough, but for now, the hard dive on towards Otter. They try to blow up Sivir's spell shield and flash away. Does block a spell. Still, though, very disruptive. Flare's gonna get stunned up by Dodo, killed off by Nian. Golden Glue Zonya's doesn't buy some more time. 3 kills picked up by teammate. This game constantly back and forth. Fantasy owners be happy about this one. Another cooldown popped. Righteous Glory by the Annie. Binding hits flares, maybe that's a bit of a window in. A good amount of damage can be dealt. Cali Trolls barely feels the poke back from enemy esports. And can always heal back up. He gets 21 health a second while under the effects. Butterdrop goes in, does not find the stun on Nian.
That's dangerous.
An ult in Dota. This could be the fight that wins teammate the game. The hard dive comes in. Cali Trolls the front lines. The kill already comes through to flares. Inox getting chased around. Trashy can't go much of anywhere except back. An axe to buy some time, but teammate are in control.
They only get one thanks to enemies disengaged, but Porpoise is on the hunt.
To win the game for teammate, Porpoise pushed around a little bit, but one more tunnel could get him the kill on a Trashy. Black Shield's on a little bit too late. The stun's gonna buy some time. Enemy needs to heal though. Keep in mind the inhibitor is dead. Cali Trolls does not have flash to land a chain.
Oof, just trying to close distance.
Might use my Trashy to buy some time
as
well.
They still only have a one number advantage. They're maybe going to try to push with these super minions, but it would be too dangerous to push in against 4 people.
And that was the Baron attempt. Keep
my now they dare for
the
Baron.
Team.
Yep. They can actually kill it pretty quickly now. They know that Olaf is going to be in the base coming out with home guards. They peel for a really early fight.
Orpheus goes for the flank. Baron secured cleanly by Nian. And the battle begins. Dodo buys a lot of time. It's a 2-man stun here. Locks up body drop. And Flare's forced to run. The tank not tanky enough. Nian is still on the chase. Golden Glue gets the kill. A 1-0. What can enemy even find? Golden Glue flashes to find more. Engages. Enemy forced to run away from this one. Kalitros lands the taunt. Body drop forced to run. This could be the fight that wins teammate the game. They've got their second kill in, still chasing towards the back line, as that's going to be 3 kills and 4 kills, and Inox, the last man alive, they can leave him up. Who cares? Tell the rest of your friends that teammate's going for the base.
Oh man, 4 down for enemy. Porpoise Rek'Sai's back to come back from Aspect of the Dragon. So many misplays by teammate in this game, but they grit through it here. Now with the Baron buff, 4 people still alive, and only Inox trying to defend. They're going for the win.
There's almost no chance Inox defends this one in the 1v4. Waiting for the minion wave. Here they go with the Baron buff for Nexus turret number 1. Claimed easily. Calitrol's on the hunt. Yeah, good luck with that
one. You cannot touch him. This is what we thought would happen with the armor stacking, and it finally did.
And it happened after all. Tech turret number one, turret number two, 49-minute win, but that's going to be the game. Teammate and get their third win of the split by knocking down enemy esports.
Whew. 48 minutes, nearly 49. Cali Trolls knows that there are many improvements for the team, shaking his head after that victory. But guess what? Still a victory. And they're now 3-7. They're ahead of enemy in the standings. They've 2-0'd them on the split.